Amen.
Sorry to say that one is we're going to pray a prayer point. If you dominate flesh, you dominate sin. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Father, as flesh, the power of flesh is dead, let the spirit of lust and sin die with it in the name of Jesus Christ. Open up and pray.
Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, by the power of flesh has been destroyed in my life, by the power of God, by the power of the Spirit, in the mighty name of Jesus, whatever it is that it is, go down with the power of God, in the name of Jesus, I see that no more happens over my life, in the mighty name of Jesus. I no longer have dominion over my life in the name of Jesus. Because the power of flesh has been conquered forever in my life. I no longer have dominion over my life. Lord, I no longer have dominion over my life. The word is the name of my life. By the grace of God, by the power of God, the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Lord.
Let me read through Ephesians chapter 2. We get to encourage it again for a deeper understanding. Amen.
Amen.
Ephesians chapter 2, I read from verse 1 to the end. You have he quickened who were dead in trespasses and sin. Wherein in the time past you walk according to the course of the world, according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit that now walketh in the children of disobedience. Verse 3, among whom also we all had our conversation in the time past, in the lust of our flesh, fulfilling the desire of the flesh and of the mind. And we are by nature the children of wrath, even as others. Verse 4. But God, who is rich in mercy, for his great love wherewith he loved us. Verse 5. Even when we were dead in sins, hath quickened us together with Christ. By grace he has saved. Verse 6. And hath raised us up together and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. That in the ages to come, he might show the exceeding riches of his grace in his kindness towards us through Christ Jesus. Verse 8. For by grace are you saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is the gift of God. 9. Not of works, lest any man should boast. Verse 10. For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus, unto good works, which God hath before ordained that we should walk in them. Verse 11. Wherefore, remember that you being in time past Gentile in the flesh, who are called uncircumcision, but by that which is called the circumcision in the flesh made by hands. Verse 12, that at that time ye were without Christ, being aliens from the commonwealth of Israel, and strangers from the covenant of promise, having no hope, and without God in this world. Verse 13, but now in Christ Jesus, you who sometimes were far off are made near by the blood of Jesus Christ. 14. For he is our peace, who had made both one and had broken down the middle wall of partition between us. Verse 15. Having abolished in his flesh the enmity, even the law of commandment contained in ordinance, for to make in himself of twain one new man, to making peace. Verse 16. And that he might reconcile both unto God in one body by the cross, having slain the enmity thereby. 17. I came and preached peace to you which were afar off, and to them that were near. Verse 18. For through him we both have access by one Spirit unto the Father. Verse 19. Now, therefore, ye are no more strangers and foreigners, but fellow citizens with the saints and of the household of God. Verse 20. And are built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets, Jesus Christ himself being the chief cornerstone. Verse 21. In whom all the building fitly framed together groweth unto an holy temple in the Lord. Verse 22 and the last. In whom ye also are builded together for an habitation of God through the Spirit. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah!
This is what the Lord has come to do for us today. When we are walking according to the flesh, we were aliens. We were far from the Lord. Though we said we were born again, but in the recess, we are so far from Him. But today, He has come by Himself to redeem us from the power of flesh, to destroy that middle partition, separating us from God. Flesh was separating us from God. But today, the Lord has come to destroy that power of flesh and make us to sit down, even with God Himself, in the heavenly places. And so shall we ever be there in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Today, amen. Don't think to yourself again the way you used to think before. I want you to understand that even though Christ has not come, you are already settled for heaven in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
But one thing we should do is to remain in Him. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Whatever will make us to go back to sin, I pray the Lord Jesus Christ Himself have destroyed that thing now in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We have been redeemed, and I pray that Spirit that raised Jesus Christ from the dead, the same Spirit will enter our body today as we eat His body and drink His blood, and we shall no longer fulfill the works of flesh again, the lust of the flesh again, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And that's really weakening our mortal body, as He said in Romans 8, verse 11. Every spiritual dullness, spiritual waywardness, spiritual blindness, spiritual deafness, spiritual daftness, the Lord, body, and blood will destroy them today in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And we all shall be quickened to do the will of God in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Please, I want you to go back home, read it again. There are many things the Lord will show you there to make you know who you are now. What we could not do for ourselves 2 days ago, we could not do it. Some of us, we are still wallowing in flesh, wallowing in sin, still lie, still do things, still do things that are contrary to the will of God. But today, those power have been put down. We shall do them no more in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Today we are saved now by the power in the blood of Jesus Christ. We all shall remain saved to the end of time in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And whenever we want to jump out of the road, the Lord will hold us tight and say, you are going nowhere. Remain here.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I love that song that says, we hold on the rock hold us. The rock hold us. That rock will hold us forever in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now, I want to raise up the bread now. Yes, bread. And the drink, whatever drink we are using, which is non-alcoholic drink. Raise up. I want to pray and say, Lord, we are at the peak of it now. Is there anything in my life still that is still there that still want to stand against my eating your body and drink your blood? Or that will still make me to eat and drink and go back and die and be weakened and still believe in the sin? Father, let that sin be taken away now. In the name of Christ. Open up. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, my Father, my God, I pray, as I raise this bread and this before you, Father, whatever was put in my life, oh God, that would disenfranchise me, Father, that make me to eat and drink, oh God, not to eat and drink steak, Lord Jesus, let that, oh God, be taken away now, in the name of Jesus Christ, let that sin be taken from us now. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father, help us, O God, deep into our body, deep into our spirit, deep into our flesh, O God, deep into, O God, our soul, and pull away that thing that will make us to eat, drink, and die, to feed the wicked. In the name of Jesus Christ, every power of Jesus Christ, come away. In Jesus, mighty name, we have prayed and prayed.
Amen.
Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, ancient of days, we come before you. Father, you ask us to do this in remembrance of you. Father, by remembering you, Father, you will be working out those things that need to be worked out for our life in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, I know heaven is celebrating us. I know, oh God, those things we could not do before, we start doing them now in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father, I bring the breads and the drinks before you. Almighty God, I pray. Father, for our qualification, we are not qualified to come before you. Father, we raise up, O God. Father, the bread and the drink, O God, above the earth, above the first and second heaven, unto the third heaven. Father, use it, O God, passage, walking through the mercy and the grace in Christ. To the righteousness of Christ, we approach you, O Lord. I ask, O God, collect, O God, the bread and the drink from our hands, O Lord. Father, anything defiling them, anything that is contrary to you, anything, O God, that is of the devil, through the company that produced them, to the market you said that we bought them from. Father, let us see the taking away now in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father, I pray and I ask, O God, that you turn all the bread into the broken body of our Lord Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, in the same way, we are pleading and asking, turn all the drinks into the precious blood of our Savior, our Lord Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you for handing them back to us again so that we can go and eat and drink, oh God, and live and prepare our way for heaven. So therefore, as we eat and drink, oh God, the power of flesh, Father, is now perpetually dead forever in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father, those things, oh God, working in the body of your children, all those fibroids, all those serpentine spirits, all those covenants that we are still there. Father, today, as we eat and drink your blood, dead forever in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father, above all, eat and drink. On the last day, no man, no woman, no child on this mountain shall be missing in heaven in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The door of hell is locked forever. We'll never enter that place again forever in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The grace to do your word. The grace to study your word. The grace to do your will. We all receive it now. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Please, Apostle, please read Matthew 26 or 1 Corinthians 11.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Matthew chapter 26. Reading from verse 26. And as they were eating, Jesus took bread and blessed it and broke it and gave it to disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body." And he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of it, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many for the remission of sins." 29. But I say unto you, I will not drink henceforth of this fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We have heard it. It's the ordinance the Lord says we should be doing. And it's expecting us to come to him in heaven on the last day, and we all shall be there in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now, so I read the one for the bread again, for the body again, so that we'll take the body.
Verse 26. And as they were eating, Jesus took bread.
Now get your body now, the body of Christ. The body of Christ. Hold it in your hand. Yes, sir.
And as they were eating, Jesus took bread and blessed it and broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body."
Now, you can eat it now. The body, the broken body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Eat it meditatively. Have it in mind that as you are eating it, the power of death, the power of flesh, the power that is subduing you, the power of bad dream, evil dream, that consumed today in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Verse 27. And he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it to them, saying, drink ye all of it, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many for the remission of sins.
Now get the blood of Christ, drink it as you enter a fresh covenant with him today, covenant of peace, covenant of life, covenant of heaven, a covenant of joy, of progress, a covenant of walk in the Spirit, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And drink it now. Hallelujah.
Yeah, praise the Lord.
Oh, Mount, I do celebrating, thanking. But finally, it is done. Finally,
my life.
Victory has been declared. Finally, we are declared victorious. Finally, we are declared
right.
We are declared heaven. We are declared a winner.
Amen.
Love of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
It is every time.
Blessing time.
Amen.
Amen.
We'll never be tired in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We have been energized again. No more weaknesses. Strength has come again in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And then we'll be meeting again by 9 o'clock CET for Digging Deep Bible Study. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you, Apostle. Peace. Close the prayer.
God bless you, my leader. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, we bless you, we adore you, we give you all the glory, we give you all the honor, we give you all the adoration for your grace and strength that you gave to us, O Lord, to wait upon you. For you sent me all to pray and not to faint. Father, Lord God Almighty, as you have declared upon our life, by using your servant, O Lord, this very hour, we have dominated every powers of the flesh forever in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, as you have sanctified us, as you have purified us, we will not entangle ourselves again into sin in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, all that you have done in our life today shall remain permanent. You will come to take us home in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, we thank you, we worship you, we bless you, we adore you. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. Father, Lord God Almighty, we thank you, Lord, on behalf of your servant. You have used this hour mightily from morning till now. Father, we pray that you continue to strengthen and empower him, O Lord. Father, your servant will walk and never stumble. Let your strength continue to increase in him. Make the vision brighter and clearer in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, as many of us that you have brought to walk with him, Father, Lord God Almighty, grant us the grace and strength to walk in unity, in love. Let bitterness, anger, hatred be far from every one of us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father, Lord God Almighty, grant every one of us, O Lord, the grace to run this race, O Lord, to the end.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Father, we thank you, Lord, for the tithes and offering. We thank you, Lord, for as many that have clapped unto you. Father, for the advancement of your work. Father, we pray that you bless every one of us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Blessed be your most holy name.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name, we pray with thanksgiving.
Amen.
The grace of fellowship.
The grace
of our Lord
Jesus Christ.
The love of God.
And the sweet
fellowship
of the Holy Spirit,
grace
and
with us all
now and
forevermore.
And surely,
Lord,
God's goodness
and mercy
is
following us
all.
All the days
of our life,
we dwell in the presence of the Most High God forever.
Let us shout, have mercy on us, O Lord.
Have mercy on us, O Lord.
Victory in the name of Jesus Christ. And glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory to Jesus Christ.
Amen. And everything that I've done for today shall remain permanent in Jesus' name.
Amen.
God bless you all. See you again 9 p.m.
Bye-bye.